Hello and welcome to the section of the Circuit Analysis Tutor. Here we're going to start talking about voltage divider circuits, and in the subsequent sections we'll talk about current divider circuits. So these topics go a little bit hand in hand, they're very similar to one another. But here we're going to focus on what we call the voltage divider. It's a very simple kind of circuit that has a very specific purpose, and it's very descriptive. It says we're going to divide the voltage, we're going to divide the voltage up, right? So what that means is, let's say I have a power supply that is plugged into the wall and it's feeding my circuit with a, let's say I convert it to DC, so it's a DC guy, or let's say I have a battery, a 12 volt battery or something like that. But let's say that that battery I have is the only battery I have and it's 12 volts. But let's say my circuit doesn't operate at 12 volts. Let's say my circuit is like a computer. Lots of computer chips, especially older ones, operate at 5 volts. And a lot of them operate at lower voltages now, but let's say that your circuit, for whatever reason, only operates at 5 volts. That's all it needs, that's all it wants. If you give it more than that, you'll burn the thing up, right? So you would like to somehow use this battery that's 12 volts to supply your circuit that only needs 5 volts. So you really want to figure out a way to do that. Now there's many ways to do that, but one way to do it is to design a voltage divider. Some combination of resistors that I'll show you that we can do that will split that voltage up, that 12 volts up, so that I can tap off 5 volts of it, let's say, and then use that for some purpose, some load, which is our circuit that we're trying to do. So when we talk about loads, you know, we're talking about the function we're doing, the circuit that's operating. When we connect the load, we're connecting whatever it is we're using, whatever it is we're powering. All right, so that's the big picture of what we're trying to do. Let me show you how you might pull that off. Let's say in this case, instead of 12 volts, let's make it a little bit easier. Let's say we have 10 volts. And let's say I connect this guy like this. Believe it or not, this is a voltage divider circuit. We just never really told you that. So, you know, get it out of your head that it's difficult. It's stuff that we've been learning all the time. I just never really told you it's a voltage divider. And let's say we have 5 ohms for this resistor and 5 ohms for this resistor. Take note, these two resistors are the same value. They are the same. All right, now let me show you what's actually happening here. So what we have here is there's some current I flowing, obviously, and it's flowing through both of these guys. Let me switch colors. And you know from our example so far that when the current flows through this resistor, there will be a voltage drop. And then when it goes through the following resistor, it will be another voltage drop. So this voltage drop, it goes looks plus to minus, and it has a voltage drop V, and then this resistor has a voltage drop V. And you know from Kirchhoff's laws before that this voltage drop plus this voltage drop must equal the 10 volts. Because if you do a Kirchhoff loop here, this is a simple circuit, you could do a loop, right? The 10 volts here minus this, or I should say the way it would work is if you did a loop, it would be whatever voltage is here plus whatever voltage is here has got to, minus this voltage up here, because this is negative, has got to be equal to zero. So the sum of these voltages have to add up to the 10 volts. I mean, when you look at it, the thing is physically connected to the source. So the 10 volts is across the whole thing. So the voltage here and the voltage here, V1 and V2, if you want to call it that, they must sum up to 10 volts. Now, how do they do that? Well, the punchline is, because I've chosen the same value, the actual value of 5 ohms doesn't really matter. What's more important is that I've chosen the same value here as I have for here. And because I have done that, this is very important, because I have done that, the voltage across this top thing is going to be 5 volts, and the voltage across this bottom resistor